Apollo 11, Houston, about a minute and a half to LOS. You're looking great. Been a mighty fine day.
Oh, you're not kidding.
This is Apollo Control. We've had loss of signal as Apollo 11 went around the backside of the moon on the 27th rev. We'll have acquisition with Apollo 11 approximately 45 minutes from now at, let's see, would you believe they don't have the next tables up for the next rev? At any rate, 45 minutes from now. And at 129 hours, 4 minutes, ground elapsed time, this is Apollo Control.
This is Apollo Control at 129 hours, 13 minutes. Apollo 11 is now 36 minutes, 40 seconds from coming around the other side of the moon for reacquisition on the 28th revolution. We're nearing the end of the 27th revolution at this time on the backside of the moon. Armstrong and Aldrin should be involved in preparing for transferring back to the command module with Mike Collins. They'll be cleaning up equipment and vacuuming off any particles of dust that remain before transferring to the command module. About 15 minutes after we reacquire, we would expect Neil Armstrong to be ready for the transfer to the command module. Buzz Aldrin to follow along behind about 30 or 40 minutes later. Here in Mission Control, we're presently completing the shift change. Flight Director Gene Kranz is replacing Glenn Lunny. And the capsule communicator on this shift will be astronaut Charlie Duke. The change of shift briefing is scheduled to occur in the news center at 6 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 129 hours, 14 minutes, this is Apollo Control, Houston.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 130 hours, 16 minutes. We reacquired Apollo 11 about 25 minutes ago at 129.51. At that time, Mike Collins reported that all three crewmen were in the command module. The transfer occurring while the spacecraft were on the backside of the moon. They had closed out the LEM early and had transferred to the secondary coolant loop. A decision was made in mission control. Because the secondary loop was on, the primary loop disabled in the closeout process. We did not want to have the LEM docked to the CSM for an undue length of time because the primary guidance system is not cooled. The decision was initially made to jettison the LEM at 130 hours, 30 minutes. However, the crew continued ahead of schedule. They were ready to jettison ahead of that time. And Collins reported at 1:30:10, about 17 minutes ago, that they were had jettisoned the LEM. And he said it had departed at several feet per second. And we heard a comment from Buzz Aldrin that he noticed some cracks in the thermal covering around the LEM tunnel docking area. However, he said it did not appear to be a structural crack, but merely some cracks in the thermal covering. We're currently scheduled to perform the small reaction control system maneuver with the command and service module for separation from the LEM at 130 hours, 30 minutes, or about 12 minutes from now. We'll pick up this pass as it began on tape, and when we've caught up, we'll continue to follow the activities live.
Hello, Eagle. Houston, do you read? Over.
Houston, this is Columbia reading you loud and clear. We're all three back inside. The hatch is installed. We're running a pressure integrity check. Everything is going well.
Roger, Eagle. Correction, Roger, Columbia. We copy. You guys are speedy. You beat us to the punch here. We had a couple of things for you.
What are they?
Oh, it was just, we wanted you to close the CO2 sensor breaker and give us an RCS onboard readout out of Eagle, but that's all. Columbia, Houston, we got a state vector for you. If you give us poo and accept, over.
Now, Buzz says the CO2 sensor circuit breaker is in.
All right, thank you very much.
The RCS quantity was approximately 60 in A and 45% in B.
Roger.
And we're going boo and accept.
Roger, thank you. Columbia, Houston, your friendly white team's going to be on till we get you on the way home, and we'd like to congratulate everybody on a successful rendezvous and a beautiful EVA. It was a great show for everybody. Over.
Thank you, sir. I'll tell them about. Houston, the hatch passes its integrity check. I'm going to go to LEM tunnel vent now and leave it there.
Roger, Columbia, we copy. That's good. And we'd like a readout on the GET of about the time you that Eagle selected the secondary loop. Over.
Roger,
Apollo Columbia Houston. We got the load in. You can do the VERP 66 and the computer's yours. Over.
Roger. Houston, Apollo 11. I'd say that the secondary loop was actuated about 15 to 20 minutes ago. Over.
Roger, copy, Columbia. Thank you very much. Columbia, Houston, it looks like you guys are so speedy on us that we're thinking about moving up jettison time to about a GET of 130 plus 30, if that's okay with y'all. Over.
Yeah, that's fine. I've still got to get a
P-30
pad from you.
Roger. We want to talk to you about that. Mike, we can, for your druthers, we can do it either way. We can either let you do it in the jettison in P-47, or we can send you a P-30 target load up, and then you let you call P-41, whichever you want to do. Over.
Yeah, I see. Ryan was going to give me a P-30 pad and a flight plan to the P-47. Other two, I prefer to go to P-30, P-41 route.
Roger, beautiful. We got the load. If you'll give us poo and accept, we'll send you a load up. Stand by. Columbia, Houston, we'd like you to terminate direct O2 flow and stand by on your poo and accept. We'll have to generate a new load due to the move up on time. Over.
Roger.
Go.
Columbia, Houston, over.
Go ahead.
Roger, Mike. It looks like if we move up this jettison time and give you a new load, it would require a new attitude, and we can't do that due to the limb already closed out. It would fight us all the way around, and we'd lose comm with it. We're thinking about separating in P-47 in about 10 minutes. We're looking at the trajectories, and we'll be back with you momentarily. Over.
Okay, it's no big thing with me either way.
Roger. Hello, Columbia, Houston. We'd like you to start down your jettison checklist. We recommend picking up page F11-12, and we'd like to jettison at 10 minutes. That'll be 130-1445. Over.
Right.
Columbia, Houston, if you can't, if that doesn't, not satisfactory, let us know. Over. Columbia, Houston, you gotta go.
Thank you.
Columbia, Houston, you can undock at your convenience, correction, jettison at your convenience. We would like you to jettison Eagle and station keep in P-47 and station keep, and we'll have another attitude and a maneuver for you such that we'll be okay for TEI. Over.
Roger that. Yeah, I'm standing by to go to P-47 as soon as you give me a go for firearm.
All right, I thought we gave you that. Mike, your go for firearm and your go for jettison.
Okay, Lunar go in 10 seconds.
Copy out.
Down 83 reading, -4 balls 3, -3 balls 3, and, or correction, minus, both register 1 and register 2 are reading -4 balls 3. Register 3 is zeros, the EMS remained on 100.0. Fairly loud noise, and it appears to be departing, I would guess, several feet per second.
Roger, can you try to station keep with it, Mike? Just stand by now.
Will do.
Columbia, Houston, don't try to chase it. Just hold what you got.
Charlie, did all cap pressure this time?
Say again, buzz, over.
Okay, I trusted back, buzz, over. I thrust it back toward it a little bit, Charlie, and I'm now reading 983 plus 4 balls 4 minus 4 balls 8, and you want me to kill average G, right?
Stand by. That's affirmative. You can exit P47.
There she goes. It was a good one.
Roger, Dodger. We got Eagle looking good. It's holding cabin pressure, and it picked up about 2 feet per second from that jettison.
I believe that. I can see some cracks in the outer coating around the tunnel. In the thermal protective covering. I don't think it has anything to do with structure.
Roger. Hello, Columbia, Houston. We'll have a attitude and a little blip burn for you at about 130 so we can separate from Eagle. Over.
That's fine.
Columbia, Houston, would you start a maneuver to about pitch of 230 for this little tweak burn? Over.
Roger, pitch 230.
Roger, Mike, and verify track mode in auto for the high gain.
Yeah, we're in react, is that all right?
Say again? We need auto.
Say again, we're in react, auto react.
Roger, we need auto, please, sir.
There you go. Roll 0, pitch 320, yaw 0.
Right now, that's what we're looking at. Stand by. We might have you roll so we can keep the high gain. Stand by.
Roger.
Columbia, Houston, over.
Go ahead.
Roger, Mike.
Apollo 11 these days.
Oh, Roger. Apollo 11. We got you going to a posi-grade attitude, and we want you, this burn will be using minus X thrusters. At about 2 or 3 feet per second, and we got a load for you, and we'll send it up momentarily. Over.
Okay.
Apollo 11, Houston, would you give us two and accept? We have a load for you. Over.
You got it.
Roger, Mike. And our pitch attitude's a little wrong here. If you're ready to copy, I'll give you the set pad. Over.
Go ahead, ready to copy.
Roger, starting with noun 33, 130, 30, 00, 00, plus 00020, plus all zeros, plus all zeros, roll all zeros, pitch 230. Y'all, zero. Noun 44 is NA. Delta VT, 0-0-0-2-0. Burn time, 0-0-7. Delta VC, 0-0-0-2-0. We have, the rest of the pad is NA.
Roger, GT, 130 hours, 30 minutes, Delta BX 2.0, roll 0, pitch 230, yaw 0, Delta VT 2.0.
That's affirmative, Apollo 11. And Mike, it's similar to the set burn prior to the right after undocking here. And P41, you should see in register 1, 2, and then you can burn minus X till you read 4. Over. Apollo 11, Houston, computer's yours. Over.
Roger, Charlie. We switched out on the details, and I lost that last transmission. Would you say again, please? The thing I'm wondering about specifically is that earlier you said it would be minus X thrusters, and the band indicate plus X. Do you want me to null that to zero, or do you want to add two and leave it as a four?
Roger. Apollo 11, the way we gave it to you and the attitude we're in, it'll be just like the set burn that you had yesterday. You'll see 985 will give you plus 2, and then you just burn minus X till you read 4, over.
Understand.
Apollo 11, Houston, we see you in P-41 now. It might take you a couple of minutes to integrate these vectors that we gave you. And if you don't make TIG, it's pretty insensitive. You can just let P-41 bring you up the TIG, and when you get zero, you can burn on that, over.
Okay. Okay, burn complete. Residuals plus 3 balls, 4, 0, plus 4 balls, 7, plus 4 balls, 2. Delta V counter 102.1, over.
Copy, Apollo 11. Looks good to us, over.
Apollo 11, how about coming up with a good communications attitude for us to go to between now and the time we maneuver to TGI attitude?
Roger, sir. Stand by. Hello, Apollo 11, Houston, a couple of things for you, over.
Go ahead.
Okay, Mike, you can maneuver to your preliminary TEI attitude as shown on page 398 of the flight plan. And the high gain angles are good as shown in the flight plan. And we'd like you to dump the wastewater at 13105 down to 10%, over.
Okay, I understand. I'm going to go to roll 1.1, pitch 0 or 5, 2.6, and yaw 13.8, and you want a wastewater dump to 10% starting at 13105.
That's affirmative, right after LOS.
Maneuvers in progress, Houston.
Copy, 11 out. Apollo 11, Houston, over.
This is Apollo Control at 130 hours, 46 minutes. That command module separation maneuver, which occurred at 130 hours, 30 minutes, was a 2 foot per second retrograde burn. Burn duration was 7 seconds. The flight dynamics officer reports that at trans-earth injection, which is scheduled to occur as per the flight plan at about 135 hours, 25 minutes, and at that time the CSM will be about 20 miles ahead of the LEM and about 1 mile below.
Apollo 11 on the high gain, how you read?
5 by 11, how many over?
You're loud and clear, Charlie. What number are you looking at for TEI tick preliminary, 135 hours, 23 minutes, something like that?
That's affirmative. Mike, we're looking at about nominal time. We considered it kicking it up a rev, but we don't think this rev tracking is going to be any good since we had the RCS burn, and so we need some more tracking to get you a good TE hour.
That's what we're looking for.
All right, sir. No, 11, Houston, looks like it'll be a pretty relaxed time here for the next couple hours. We'll have you pad, of course, next rev or so, and we'll keep you posted on the, looks like nominal time, over.
Thanks, sir.
And your little maneuver back there a moment ago, will put you about 20 miles ahead of the LEM at TEI.
Imagine the place is cleared out a little bit after that rendezvous. You can find a place to sit down almost, huh?
Roger, our mocker's about empty right now. We're taking it a little easy. How's it feel up there to have some company?
Damn good, I'll tell you.
I bet. I bet you can almost be talking to yourself up there after 10 revs or so.
No, no, it's a happy home up here. It'd be nice to have some company. Matter of fact, it'd be nice to have a couple hundred million Americans up here.
Roger, well, they were with you in
just
spirit.
See what they're getting for their money.
Roger, they were with you in spirit anyway, at least that many. We heard on the news today, 11, that last night after you, yesterday after you made your landing, the New York Times came out with a headlines, the largest headlines they've ever used in the history of the newspaper.
Send us a copy. I'm glad to hear it was fit to print.
It was great.
That's why we didn't read you up any newscast today. There really wasn't anything to talk about.
Hello there, boss.
Apollo 11, Houston, we got 10 minutes to LOS. See you over the hill at 131.48, over.
Okay, Charlie, I'll dump the water as soon as we go around the corner.
Roger, everything's looking real good now.
Yeah, same here.
Apollo 11, Houston coming up to about 430 LOS. You're looking great on all your systems. Eagle spurring right along on after an hour 30 on without any cooling of things is still looking good. Over.
Roger.
Apollo 11, Houston, would you verify that your rendezvous radar transponder is off? Over.
It's not, but I'll get it off.
Roger. We were seeing some, believe it or not, we were seeing some funnies in the Eagle's rendezvous radar, and that was the only theory we had. It looked like it was a good one.
A theory?
This is Apollo Control. We've had loss of signal now. At the present time, we show Apollo 11 in an orbit with a high point of 62.6 nautical miles and a low point or paracynthian of 54.9. The spacecraft is traveling at a speed of 5,355 feet per second. We'll reacquire the spacecraft in a little over 45 minutes on the 21st revolution. At 131 hours, 3 minutes, this is Apollo Control, Houston.
Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 131 hours, 48 minutes. We're standing by to reacquire Apollo 11. Acquisition should come in about 5 seconds. This revolution should be relatively quiet. We don't have a great deal of activity scheduled. The crew may have time here to get something to eat. And here on the ground, we'll be computing the information needed for their trans-Earth injection burn. We do have data now from the spacecraft. We'll stand by for a call to the crew.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston. We're standing by. Everything is looking great here. Over.
Apollo 11, Roger.
This is Apollo Control. We suspect that the crew are having something to eat at this time, which probably accounts for the relatively quiet period. One of the things that we're watching with interest here in Mission Control is the lunar module. At the time Aldrin and Armstrong left the LAM and came back into the command and service module, they switched over to the secondary coolant loop as part of a test that we're running to determine just how long the primary guidance and navigation system will last without cooling. The primary guidance system is not cooled on the secondary loop, which provides backup cooling for the secondary guidance system. And it's always been a point of interest just how long the primary guidance system will survive without the cooling. Estimates range up to several hours. The LEM telecom controller reports that this time we are seeing some rise in the PIPAs. These are the pulse integrating pendulous accelerometers, which the primary guidance system uses to detect changes in motion and attitude. And of course they are an essential item in the primary guidance system. We are seeing a gradual rise in temperature, but the telecom engineer reports that the primary guidance system still looks very good. At the time, the crew reported they were back, Armstrong and Aldrin reported they were back in the command module. We asked them at what time they had switched over to the secondary loop. Armstrong estimated that that occurred about 129 hours, 40 minutes, which was a little over 2 hours ago. We will continue to monitor the LEM and to observe the performance of the primary guidance system. All systems on the command and service module continue to function very well at this time, and the same can be said for the lunar module. At the present time, we show Apollo 11 in an orbit 62.5 nautical miles by 54.2, a spacecraft traveling at a speed of 5,349 feet per second.